So, you were given a decision aid sheet about prostate cancer screening when you checked in today. Did you get a chance to review that?
Oh yeah, I mean, I read it in the waiting room. No one in my family's had prostate cancer, so I mean, should I even be worried about it?
Well, about 1 in 7 men like you who are at average risk will at some point be diagnosed with prostate cancer. It's the most common major cancer in men. Also, the risk goes up for men over 50. For about 1 in 38 men, prostate cancer will be the cause of their death.
Okay. Good to know. I've heard that doctors disagree about testing for prostate cancer, though. What do you think about it?
Well, there are pros and cons to the test. Getting tested every 1 to 2 years could reduce your risk of dying from prostate cancer by 20 to 30%. But the test can also lead to harm. For some men, not getting tested and avoiding the harm is the right choice, even though they lose a small benefit. It's complicated, so let's talk it through. We don't have to come to a decision today.
Okay.
PSA stands for prostate-specific antigen. The test for prostate cancer is a blood test that measures your PSA level. A high PSA level might mean prostate cancer, but it could also mean things that aren't cancer, like an enlarged prostate. Does this make sense so far?
Yeah, I think so.
Because we don't know for sure what's causing a high PSA level, we do more tests to find out. If more tests showed that the likelihood of prostate cancer was high enough, then I might recommend a prostate biopsy.
Okay, and if you found cancer, then I'd get treatment, right?
Unfortunately, that's not an easy answer. The action we take would depend on how likely it is that the cancer we found will cause harm. Not all prostate cancer is dangerous.
But I thought all cancer was dangerous and could spread?
Well, unlike a lot of other types of cancers, most prostate cancers grow very slowly and won't cause problems or need treatment. So treating these cancers could do more harm than good. But harmful cancers can spread, and treatment is needed to stop them. The tough part is that we can't always tell which cancers are harmful and which ones would grow slowly and never need treatment.
If you did find the harmful kind, what would the treatment be?
Treatment is usually surgery, radiation, or both. There are side effects, like urine leakage. And some men also experience impotence. They can no longer get an erection. Blood clots and heart attacks are much less common, but those are possibilities following any major surgery. So what do you think about that?
Those are some serious side effects I would definitely like to avoid.
Well, if I was confident that a cancer was most likely harmful, I'd recommend treatment in most cases. But if the cancer didn't appear to be harmful, there would be another option called active surveillance. Choosing this option could mean that you'd avoid the possible side effects of treatment.
Can you explain that option?
Sure. We would keep a close eye on your prostate for a long time by doing a PSA test every few months and repeating the biopsy from time to time. Maybe even doing an MRI of the prostate too. If the cancer grows, we'd reconsider treatment.
That sounds okay. But is active surveillance safe?
We're still studying it, and there's a lot we don't know for sure. There's some risk with active surveillance that cancer cells could spread before we see the cancer is growing. At that point, it might be too late for prostate surgery or radiation to cure the cancer. So what do you think about this, the active surveillance option?
Well, I know I wouldn't want treatment unless you were sure I needed it. If you found something and you were pretty sure it wasn't harmful, why get treatment that could cause those side effects? With active surveillance, you just watch it closely, right?
That's right. It sounds like active surveillance is something you'd consider. That option is important for men to understand before they decide to get a PSA test.
So the first decision is the test?
Right. Then there may be decisions after the test, like we've talked about. So it's important that you know about these things as you consider what's right for you. You don't have to make a decision right now, but I'd like to know about your feelings about getting the PSA test.
I'm leaning toward getting it, but I'm worried about winding up with side effects from treatment that doesn't end up benefiting me. Do you recommend I get tested today?
No. I recommend patients do the test only if they're really sure it's right for them. So for today, I suggest you take this information sheet with you. It has answers to common questions that men have. We can talk about it more when I see you in a couple of months.
Thanks. I'll take a look and talk about it with my family too.
That sounds good.